Hi everyone, my name is Hanisha and I'm part of Azure Identity and Authentication team at Microsoft. As an admin, you may have identified an unauthorized sign-in either through self-investigation or through an end user or vendor. This video is a quick demonstration showing how you can investigate your end users getting allowed unexpectedly by conditional access policies. This will also help you to understand why a particular conditional access policy didn't block the user and what were the conditions that led to the allow. Now, let's get started. Let's start with understanding how you can identify the sign-in event which allowed the unauthorized access. For this, you will need the correlation ID, which uniquely identifies a sign-in session, or the application name, username, and timestamp to filter the sign-in logs. If you are trying to get the correlation ID from the end user, have them click on the ellipsis button here at the bottom right corner of the page when they log in, and then capture the correlation ID and then complete the sign-in. If you are unable to get this correlation ID from the end user, or if you are self-investigating, you will need the application name, username, and timestamp to identify the unauthorized sign-in event. Now let's navigate to the sign-in logs and filter with the data you have. For this demo, I have the correlation ID of the sign-in event to filter through the sign-in logs. Now click on Add Filters, choose the correlation ID, and then click Apply. From here, select the sign-in event and navigate to the Conditional Access section to check which policies don't apply and which policies have applied. In this scenario, the Conditional Access policy must block the user from accessing the Azure portal. Clicking on the context menu will show us more details that can help us understand this better. While you ensure that the policy is enabled, you can review the assignment section, which is the data used for conditional access policy evaluation. We see here the user criteria does not match with the users included in the conditional access policy. If this allow was intended, then you may not want to take any action on the conditional access policy. If not, you can make the necessary changes to the conditional access policy based on your internal requirements. Similarly, let's review the assignments for another scenario. Let's search for the policy conditional access policy block users and click on the context menu to show details. Here, the assignments clearly denotes that the application Azure portal is not included in the conditional access policy, due to which the user was able to access the Azure portal successfully. Again, if this allow was intended, then you may not want to take any action on the conditional access policy. If not, you can make the necessary changes to the conditional access policy based on your internal requirements. I hope this video is helpful and thanks for watching.